I had a professor that was talking about what freedom looks like and the different expressions, and she said something about you should be free to practice your culture or be free from your culture. And that was just something that has stuck to me ever since.
Just think back to fifth grade. How does a clique work?
I think there are a lot of different kinds of good teaching, and I'm really pleased that Berkeley is able to recognize that variety. I think it's immensely important to not put us all into one kind of box.
And I'm sure for all of you,
the most important thing for me is for students in my classes to feel that they are valued and that they have been heard.
And the first brief is
I think an ability to listen and learn from your students is critical. I think respect for your students is important.
There's a magical moment that's about to happen. We will make a link to chemistry.
One of the most important things I tell my students is if they're worried about a grade, just imagine they got an A from day one. What's important to me is what they take away for a lifelong set of goals, a lifelong learning experience.
One option is it.
I love seeing the diamond in the rough. When they finish the course, they know something. Not something that they've memorized, not something that is just part of a textbook, but something that they feel is a piece of them that they own.
A good teacher is somebody who comes to the classroom every day that's excited about what they do, excited about what they're working on. They help you see how it's going to matter to you in the long run.
A good teacher is a good leader. She combines the forces of the student's intuition with her own knowledge and makes something that's incomprehensible very, very simple.
For me, a good teacher is someone that's persistent and cares about their students. And also, they want their students to perform better than they were when they came into the classroom.
Love, for example, can be rallied as a motive for war.
Our task as teachers is not necessarily to make students passionately love the subject, but to bring a little bit of what sparked a fire for us to them and help them grow.
My goal in all the classes I teach is to create a sense of community in the classroom, that everybody's there to participate.
There's a sense that each student's contributions are valid and interesting and important.
Good morning, Toby. How are you?
The students that are in that classroom, they are the precious tokens that their parents have deposited for me. It's as if my own family has grown from two kids to very many kids.
I'm there to try to nurture and be there, but in a way that I can either be the wind beneath their wings, but I can also be the wind against their wings to try to help them build strength.
Strong technical mastery.
I learn best when I'm learning from a teacher who's passionate about what they're teaching. I learn best by being cross-examined, somebody to poke holes in my reasoning and my thought.
YLM. Learning for me has always been a two-way street. It's tremendously more effective to have immediate feedback from your students. It also helped me to figure out where have I not been clear in trying to explain something that I've been thinking about for years, whereas they've only had a few minutes to integrate.
Knowledge comes about through conversation. So the dynamic between student and teacher and student and student is absolutely crucial.
Is that a possibility? I have to be willing to digress when students seem interested in something that I hadn't planned to talk about. It's a kind of willingness to improvise, and I find that exhilarating.
Is there something that you want from me?
I think professors who care about the opinions of their students and are able to ask their opinions and give them enough information to really think about why they have those opinions creates a feeling of kind of community in the classroom.
There's just immense energy that the Berkeley students bring into that room.
I think you can feel the engagement and the interest. You have more questions, you have discussion.
There's a freedom to fail that I think is so important to the learning process, to get it wrong.
Is there like another reason why we...
By making them feel comfortable, they're willing to take risks and to keep going. I feel like that grit and resilience will determine success more than anything.
You can learn from failure, and that is a hard message to get across because our students are accustomed to being successful.
The bar is really high, and so sort of seeing students who might be struggling at first and then when it clicks, that's pretty cool.
I think the best moment in a classroom is when students get into this fierce debate amongst themselves. You leave discussion very perplexed and also really excited.
It's that activism and engagement that energizes me.
I guess the biggest thing that Berkeley offers is just the varying perspectives of the students. Being around so many different types of people allows you to understand the material better because you can expand your mind through their point of view and you can expand theirs through yours.
We all bring in different backgrounds, different experiences, different concepts. And what that does is it allows us to ask questions and tackle them in many different ways.
We're not simply educating future workers or professionals. We're educating thoughtful, discerning citizens.
The goal of Berkeley is to make sure that your mind is nimble for all sorts of different questions and ideas. And it's that openness which fuels learning.
Have an idea. Try it. Go for it. Share it. You know, you might change the world.